Participating will have to be vaccinated. But when it comes to players, his next seizure? The Leafs chief medical officer, Dr. Alan Sills, said the league does not have plans to mandate those players getting vaccinated. Sills telling the NFL Network that the league and their players' association has opted instead to prioritize vaccine education and encourage the players to get those vaccines, but saying they have to, that isn't in their plans. Now the NFL will be in line with the NBA, which is also encouraging education, but is yet to tell their players they have to be vaccinated if they plan to finish this season with their teams. Randy Carroon, KNX 1070, News Radio.
953, I'm going to say that the car prices are going up in the next few months, and the blame will fall on the computer chips. There's a shortage because semiconductor production is down, and for that, blame the pandemic. It doesn't just have to affect the new car prices, used car prices. On the increase as well. They were up 3.25 points because people who could not get their hands on a new car didn't buy the used cars.
There were some red lights in the sky above the Pacific Northwest last night, and people were thinking, some of them, ooh, maybe it was a meteor shower, but somewhat of a Cairo QD, a meteorologist in Seattle, says that it actually turned out to be some debris from the second stage of the SpaceX rocket as it burned up in the atmosphere after falling out of orbit.
This is part of a Falcon 9 rocket launched about 22 days ago. We saw it across a good part of Western Washington, even into northern Oregon. It was supposed to fall into the Pacific Ocean south of Alaska. Sort of missed the off-ramp, and it ended up coming over Western Washington.
No reports of any pieces of the rocket stage actually reaching the ground.
Southern California Edison promises to cut the number of deliver of power cuts it makes in the Santa Clarita Valley during the windy conditions to reduce the risk of a fire. Live stream during a virtual Q&A session with residents in the area, many of whom are complaining about power shutoffs that they don't think are necessary. The Santa Clarita Valley Signal says Edison officials laid out a five-step plan for system upgrades that would gradually let the utility make fewer cuts in the future.
Add us to your social media feeds because we're there for you on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And if you want to stream us, it's easy to do. You just download the radio.com app and favorite KNX 1070, 955 KNX. Coming up at the top of the hour, we're going to talk more about what's been happening the last couple of days and what's happening today out in Echo Park when it comes to the homeless and the protesters and the police. It's all coming up after CBS News. It is 9:59.
Traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the fives, and here is Brian Douglas.
Caltrans works. Sweeper train 5 north here in Commerce now up at Atlantic, making its way up to the 710. That's why you're dreadfully slow all the way back to the 605. Telegraph Road, Telegraph train off. It's wide and it's wide open. You can take that basically up to Atlantic. We join that 5. What we need to do is get that sweeper up to the 5 Stadium Way. It's got glass all over the roadway northbound side. Just heard from back to two tipsters. One of the gals said there is glass in every single lane, like auto books. So be careful when you drive. CHP knows about that. Maybe a break in place here soon. 75 North is going to be tough at least because of this off the 10 freeway. Speaking of brakes, CHP ran a break 605 South just past the 91 to fill some potholes here and take care of some graffiti. Well, Southern California Toyota Dealers 110 Jam Cam, that's still slow with this crash at Gage. We had a crash in the left lane. Looks like that's still working. It looks like that's got you backed up almost to the 105. We have a food drive at the Hollywood Bowl today till about noon.